Hello and welcome to today's webinar. Today's discussion is on a best practice topic of running your insurance agency in the cloud. And this is Darren Cunningham. I run marketing for the Informatica Cloud team, and I'm happy to have two distinguished speakers with me, Jared Buckley and Vincent Culhane. Jared, why don't you introduce yourself, and then we'll have Vincent introduce himself and his company as well.
Thanks, Darren. Hello, everyone. Name is Jared Buckley. I'm in our Alliances organization for Informatica Cloud. I work very closely with partners like Salesforce.com to help them build out solutions similar to what we're talking about today.
Great. And Vincent?
Hello, everyone. I'm Vincent Culhane. I'm Senior Managing Director of Frank Crystal & Company, in charge of operations. And I was the project lead on the Salesforce implementation as well as the integration to our agency management system.
Fantastic. So welcome, everybody. I want to remind the participants on today's webinar, we would love to make this as interactive as possible. I suspect you'll have a lot of questions for Vincent, but also as we get into some more technical topics, you're welcome to ask those as well, given that we have Jared, our subject matter expert, on the line. So please do use the chat panels on the right side of the WebEx system, and we will endeavor to make this as interactive as we can. So let's jump into today's topic. We're going to do a quick overview of Salesforce and cloud integration. We realized as we saw the registrations come in, many of you already have invested in and implemented Salesforce.com for CRM and also with the Force.com platform. But also many of you are still considering moving to a new, or for a first time, moving to a new CRM platform. So we wanted to provide a little bit of an overview of that, and certainly can point you to our friends at Salesforce for much more detail. We'll then spend a little bit of time providing an overview of the importance of integration to Salesforce success. And then we're really excited to have Vincent walk you through how they looked at the problem, how they approached, how they solved the problem at Frank Crystal, and he'll even show you that in a live demonstration. So pretty cool stuff. So with that, wanted to jump right in, and we worked with Salesforce recently. They provided a pretty detailed webinar on Salesforce in the insurance industry, and what Salesforce has seen is a very broad adoption of their platform and the CRM application in this industry, whether it's life and health insurance providers, property and casualty, and brokers. Salesforce is really now, what they're seeing is the top five insurance companies are really implementing this globally. So some pretty impressive adoption and results of Salesforce in this industry. And some of the reasons that that they've identified as, why is Salesforce becoming so successful in helping to really drive customer success in this industry? Well, they've been doing a lot of digging into, talking to their customers and really trying to understand what it is they're doing with the platform. And they've actually delivered some new, very focused, industry-centric solutions for the industry. So a lot of good momentum and adoption of Salesforce in this area. And with so many of you on the call, coming from insurance providers, there's a lot more information. What they found are that traditional AMS tools focus on administration, and they're not really used so widely for prospecting and some of the upfront sales work. So as you can see on this slide, there's been challenges to collaborate. There's been a need for producers to really become more productive and be able to focus on building relationships out in the field. So really great adoption of Salesforce in this industry. And really the key focus has been on that very topic, a topic that we know well at Informatica, which is putting the tools and information into the hands of producers who need it the most. So that's really what we're going to focus on in today's overview. What are some of the benefits of adopting a CRM and Force.com platform like Salesforce? And what is the role of integration? How can a company like Informatica help you get there, and not only get there, but help you become much more efficient and productive once you have your CRM environment connected to your existing legacy applications? So just one more slide on some of the benefits that Salesforce customers continue to tell them about the benefits of Salesforce as a platform. So really the focus on being able to focus on, you know, being able to access information anytime, anywhere. It is an on-demand system, so a cloud-based application, allowing you to log in through any device and very quickly access the information you need to be productive and efficient in your job. Some of the other areas have been around the analytics that Salesforce provides within the CRM environment. Being able to track and measure some things that you're probably, you know, you maybe doing on paper, through spreadsheets, or not even tracking and measuring at all today in your organization. And then ultimately being able to customize and adapt your process. Many traditional enterprise applications force you into the process that fits that application. And with Salesforce's easily customizable interface, you can really adapt it to the workflows and processes that work for your organization. And Informatica, I should mention, is a longtime Salesforce user, you know, customer as well. So tremendous adoption and tremendous benefits of the CRM system. So what Salesforce has also seen, and this is really the benefits of their multi-tenancy on-demand model, is that very small companies and the largest, you know, of the large enterprise insurance carriers and brokers are able to all be on the same code line, all take advantage of the same innovations that are frequently delivered with quarterly releases, or, you know, sometimes even more frequently. So what you see with a cloud-based platform like Salesforce and like Informatica is really a rapid pace of innovation and the ability for, you know, companies of all sizes to really benefit from the platform. Now, one of the challenges that we've heard time and time again from companies that have moved to software as a service, cloud-based systems, you know, people often talk about, you know, security concerns. And vendors have become very, you know, in particular Salesforce, very good at overcoming those potential objections by talking about the different SAS 2 type certifications, all of the ways that they're complying with really very, very advanced certifications and security requirements. So once the IT organization gets over any potential security concerns, what we then find is that integration is really rears its head as a major challenge. And I find this slide interesting because the question was asked, why isn't your firm interested in cloud-based or software as a service systems? And one of the reasons here, as you can see, is that challenges with the existing enterprise applications really is the number two reason why a lot of companies sit back and kind of put it off or you know, continue to work with systems that are really antiquated and aren't delivering the value that they could be to the organization. And that's really where we focused at Informatica. And I wanted to bring Jared in as our subject matter expert on the Informatica Cloud. So Jared, we've talked about, you know, what we've seen as some of the primary use cases. Maybe you can walk folks through these four use cases.
Yeah, sounds good. Thanks, Darren. So as you look, I mean, in some of these four use cases, the four boxes you see across the top, they can apply to any space, but I'll drill into the insurance space. So the one on the left, load data, I mean, that's for your initial migration. So if you're someone that is just purchasing Salesforce and just looking to migrate data from other systems into Salesforce, Informatica is a big player here. I want to focus, though, more time on the second one, which is the synchronization of data, because as Vincent's going to talk about, this is really the use case that we've seen in insurance agencies. So this is so that you have information at the right place at the right time. And that's when Informatica Cloud does very well. So you have your agency management system, maybe it's Sagita, maybe it's TAM, maybe it's AMS 360, or you've custom built something. And it's very good at administering policies, it has accounts, contacts, information in it, et cetera. But you want to get that information into the CRM application, into Salesforce, so they can be out there prospecting, making calls, upselling, and you want to deliver that data. So if they're in the field and they're using Salesforce Mobile, it's right there at their fingertips. And Informatica does that. And that's what Vincent will kind of discuss is, you know, how we do that integration. And we see it today. I would say the use cases are typically people want to sync customer information from their AMS system to Salesforce, or they want to sync policy information. They want to, and that's kind of the main focus. And Vincent's going to touch on that in his use case. And then as you move over, Informatica Cloud also has the ability to cleanse your data. So maybe you need to make sure you have valid addresses so we can help with that process, cleanse those addresses. And then we can also replicate data. If you need data to be replicated from the cloud down to your on-premise systems, we have services for that as well.
Okay, great. And I want to remind some people, we've seen a lot of people join the conference call, the presentation a little bit later. You can use the chat panels, the Q&A panels on the side if you have some questions for either Jared or Vincent as we dive into some of the more specifics here. So really quickly, just to introduce you to Informatica Cloud, some of you may know Informatica. Informatica has been, you know, is the independent market leader in data integration. And the company in 2005 really made a significant investment in building out a cloud-based solution. So what that means is you can subscribe, you can go to informaticacloud.com, you can get started with a trial, and we will help you move the data to and from systems in an automated fashion without any, you know, on-premise based software required to make that happen. So, you know, many of your organizations may already be using Informatica in-house within the IT organization, and now we have the ability to extend the reach of what's possible through the cloud. So, longtime partner with Salesforce. We've been working together since the early days. We have over 1,000 companies really taking advantage of our integration with Salesforce as a partner. And just to introduce you to some of the key capabilities, What we hear time and time again from Salesforce customers, or, you know, the benefits of the Informatica Cloud approach are, one, that like Salesforce, it is a true multi-tenant, you know, software as a service solution. We've actually been recognized for a couple of years by Salesforce as the number one data integration technology on the AppExchange. The second is ease of use. So many of you probably think of integration as very hard, complicated, and, you know, takes a lot of resources. What we've done with the Informatica Cloud is built a very easy-to-use wizard base. We've built a six-step wizard, for example, to walk you through synchronizing data between applications. So we'll show you that in a quick screenshot, and we'll ask Vincent to speak to, you know, what he's seen in his implementation as well. And then lastly, proven customer success. So, I mean, this is where I think the rubber hits the road. Is if you're a Salesforce customer or thinking about Salesforce, you want to go out to the AppExchange and you want to look for, you know, what are other customers saying about this solution? Look at, you know, look at the quality of reviews that partners are getting and the frequency and recency of those reviews. So something we're very proud of within the Informatica Cloud team. So I've got a couple of questions here, and I think we should just take them in real time. So I'm part of a two-person agency. One of us prefers Mac, one of us prefers PC, including integrating our mail clients, et cetera. Would this work? Why don't I put that over to you, Jared?
Darren, can you repeat that one time? You broke up at the very end of the question.
The question is about an organization that might want to use PCs, you know, a Mac and a desktop for integrating between mail clients. Is that something? Is that a use case for Informatica Cloud?
For integrating between mail clients?
So I'll take it. So Informatica Cloud currently can run on a Windows environment and can run on a Linux environment. We have seen some companies just download if you go to informaticacloud.com, you can download the agent and start working with it right away on your desktop. But typically, we currently don't support a Mac environment. So that is something we would want to talk to you about as a potential use case. The other question I've got is integration fully complete for AMS 360 and BenefitPoint from Vertafore? Are those systems you're familiar with, Jared?
Yeah, with AMS 360, definitely familiar with that. We do work with AMS 360 and do integration with them. And would love to learn more about the use case, you know, how you want to do it, bi-directional, et cetera, with that application.
Okay. So there is another question. I'm going to show you the browser, but the question is Salesforce and Informatica all browser-based? And absolutely. So that is the beauty of this model. You can log on anytime from your, you know, iPhone, from your, you know, any kind of browser without having to implement, you know, a whole lot of on-premise software. So pretty powerful capabilities delivered over the web. So Jared, why don't you define some of the key areas we've seen Informatica Cloud involved before we really tee up Vincent to walk through what's been going on over there at Frank Crystal?
Yeah, good point. So let me talk a little bit about, you know, how we're seeing Informatica Cloud in the insurance space. I kind of broke this into carriers, agents, and brokers. We're obviously focusing on agents and brokers today, but I do want to highlight a couple things. So, you know, carriers today are using Informatica technology, using Informatica Cloud to aggregate information and load it into their back office systems for financial reporting, et cetera. And they also will use it, carriers will use it to push data into portals for their agencies, brokers, and wholesalers so they can see kind of how the agents are doing, et cetera. And one of the, as you're probably all familiar with, one of the standards that we support and, of course, is very widely used in the insurance space is the Accord standard. So in Informatica Cloud, we support that. So if you want to exchange data on that standard with your carrier, Informatica Cloud does support that capability. And then as you drill down into agents and brokers real quick, you know, we've touched on this, and you're about to see a great case study on it, but it's the use cases are almost always very similar, and it's let's get data from the agency management system into Salesforce so that our brokers can do, so that our producers can cross-sell, have access to policies, when they term, what's the value of a customer, et cetera. And that's obviously the bread and butter in what we're talking about today.
Okay, thanks, Jared. So there's been a couple other questions. We'll take some of them towards the end that are more on the technical side. A few questions about specific applications, Agency Pro and Droids and Applied Epic. So one of the things I think you'll hear in Vincent's overview is the fact that they have moved data into a SQL-based environment. So really anything that this enterprise application is running on, if it's a, you know, any kind of, you know, SQL-based database, Informatica Cloud can easily work with you. If it's more customized or if it's a package application, we definitely want to follow up and understand more about the requirements, and we can take that as the next step. So with that, I'm going to introduce Vincent Culhane, Senior Managing Director for Frank Crystal & Company.
Hey, good afternoon. I will address the benefit point question because we use the benefit point, but I'll do that when I get to my integration. I'll show you how we do that. I'm going to start off by giving you a brief overview, and the only reason I want to talk a little bit about Frank Crystal is so that you understand our business model, so that when we get into the integration pieces and some of the workflow components of Salesforce, you'll understand why we did certain things. We're a full-service insurance broker founded in 1933. We are the 15th largest and second largest privately owned in the United States. We have over 400 employees in 11 offices. We are organized nationally, which is quite unique. So we have five business units. One of them is our business development, and those business units are all run on a national basis. So there's no geographic boundaries, which really gives us the ability to work and put together whatever team we need to, given the client's needs. And we serve clients not only throughout the United States, but around the world. We have we are a member of an international broker association, and we get both referrals into us and utilize that broker network to service clients around the world. So I'm going to take you briefly through our four what I'll call brokerage units and what they do and how they're operated, and then we'll get right into the demo. First is our commercial insurance services. This is what you would typically see as your property casualty practice, but it has a number of specialties in there. We do aviation, environmental. We have specialties in real estate, nonprofit, we're huge in. But it's a typical property casualty practice. We also have a practice that's particularly focused on the financial institution business. And you can see here the types of clients that we have in that particular practice. They're a full service in that they do not only the property casualty, they do the bonds, the professional, the, you know, all of that, all those lines of business. And then one of the things we're extremely good at is private client services. We have a very strong referral network with lots of investment firms. You can guess where we met these people. But they refer very affluent individuals throughout the United States to us. And it is a real specialty of ours. We have practices in yachts and private collectors, art collectors, things of that nature, and it's a real strength of the company. And then last but not least, we have an employee benefits services, which is your typical employee benefits, medical, life, things of that nature, all the ancillary products. And it also is forming an HRO practice, which is human resource outsourcing. So when we decided to buy Salesforce, we had several objectives that we were trying to solve. Like most companies, we had spreadsheets with suspect lists and prospects. They were not well known throughout the company. Each producer kind of kept their own. There was no ability to manage activity on those suspects, and there was no real visibility on our pipeline other than a month or two with things we were actually working on. So we had no idea whether activity was generating the right kind of pipeline to hit our new business. So when we started looking at CRMs and decided to purchase Salesforce, our goal was to really enhance the production of new and expanded business, manage our sales activities, not just what's in the pipeline, but are we making the calls? Are we having the meetings? What are we doing to network? Be able to manage that new business pipeline throughout the stages that the new business opportunity goes. And really, internally, we have a process of qualifying and assigning resources. Because our producers sit outside of our brokerage units, we qualify all the opportunities and assign resources based on the opportunities that come down the pipe. We needed a better way of tracking the outcomes of those opportunities and identify a key thing. I think a lot of you will share in this frustration. One of the best opportunities for any insurance brokerage to grow is the client base we have, cross-selling opportunities within that existing client base. And while we have the mechanism to do it and the incentive for our producers to do it, we're not very good at it, and we want to get a lot better at cross-selling and, keeping you all out of our clients, if you will. We also wanted to track referral sources. I mentioned in the private client area that we have a huge volume of referrals coming to us from centers of influences, and we needed to be able to track those and track those by the location of the referral sources. So while we may have a relationship nationally with a very large, investment bank, we needed to know which offices were referring things to us, who specifically in those offices, so that we could continue to foster their referrals, as well as identify other people that we needed to go after to try to get referrals from them. And obviously, we wanted to continue to grow ourselves and our brand and our culture. So let me give you a quick overview of the integration and how we did this, and I'll touch on the benefit point in this slide. And then I'll show you a demonstration in Salesforce of how this actually works. So within
And Vincent, there's also, as you're going through it, I think you're going to hit this, but a question was asked about, I'm still unclear on how Informatica fits in with Salesforce and the AMS, so I think it'll come out in this slide as well.
Yeah, okay. So, you can substitute AMS for Sagita in this particular slide, but we use Salesforce on the front end to manage our marketing activity and our sales activities, not just, pipeline information, but emails, marketing campaigns that we're sending out. We use it for tracking meetings and calls and all of that type of stuff. We also use it to manage new and cross-sell opportunities. So when we do have an opportunity, we start right at the front end of that process to identify what those opportunities are and see what's coming down the pipe. We use it to assign the resources, and the resources are account executives and brokers that are in those business units. Salesforce does the assignment. We do it within Salesforce. And we use it to forecast our new business revenues so that we know where we stand to budget. Informatica sits between Salesforce and Sagita. All right. What it does is it allows us to move data back and forth extremely quickly and efficiently without having to dual entry that information. And I'm going to touch on that when I get over to the types of information that are coming when I get over to Sagita. But there's no dual entry. Something we do in Sagita is in Salesforce in 5 minutes. And it goes from policy information to clients, any contacts that we might put into Sagita. That is a bi-directional, by the way, integration. Salesforce updates Sagita, Sagita updates Salesforce. And other little things that they're very important, like codes. So for instance, as we add a new producer code in Sagita, within 5 minutes it's in Salesforce and it's available to be assigned to a particular opportunity or to track activity around that person. And all the codes in Sagita get pushed up to Salesforce that we need up there automatically within 5 minutes, changes are recognized. So obviously within Sagita, or our agency management system, it's where we do all of the heavy lifting on, you know, policy maintenance, renewals, you know, all our quoting, all our accounting work is done over there. But there's certain pieces of that information that we want pushed to Salesforce, really to expose it to the sales team. You know, many of our sales people are not Sagita users. They're not going to get in there and look. And they may need it when they're on the phone talking to a client about a cross-sell opportunity. They may want to see what's going on. So that information gets pushed over constantly. It's not a nightly push, and Informatica does that integration for us.
Hey, Vincent, maybe on that point, there was a question about, you know, I think a lot of people think of integration as just loading data in. And you mentioned, I mean, here there's over 1,700 integration jobs running a day. So can you just speak to the bidirectional nature of you know, how the data is flowing to and from the system?
Yeah, so information flows through sales from Salesforce down to Sagita when we have assignments of opportunities and we're looking to create a new account from a suspect or prospect that we've been managing in Salesforce. So we push base information down, and that information includes creation of a client record in Sagita. It includes all the contact information that we have that we've been managing through Salesforce, but now we're ready to actually start working on something, create policies, maybe market something. So that gets pushed down. And then all of the information that's updated, once that push down happens, Salesforce then knows the Sagita client ID and any activity that happens on the client side, like we create new policies, we cancel a policy, we add a new contact, we update a client record, changing address or any other thing, all of that gets pushed up to Salesforce, and it happens throughout the day. That's why you see 1,700 integration jobs running every single day. So that's kind of, I hope I touched on that. Let me go ahead and show you how this pieces
as you're getting up ready for a demo. It's clear there's a lot of TAM users out there. So, I mean, this would be similar. We've seen customers doing, you know, what Vincent's going to be showing with TAM as the agency management system as well.
Yep. Yes, and I think it would be important to note that this was a custom integration. So what we did is sat down and set the business rules ourselves. From beginning to end, we decided to purchase Salesforce in late December. We had the information migrated over, the data migrated over, and the integration working within 4 months. So it was not a major project. It was probably the simplest project I've worked on. And I pointed out down here BenefitPoint. The way we are integrating with BenefitPoint is we push all the data back and forth to Sagita, and then we use Sagita to push it up to BenefitPoint. And then BenefitPoint and Sagita stay synchronized, and Sagita synchronizes with Salesforce. So it's we didn't go directly into BenefitPoint. We went to Sagita and pushed it to BenefitPoint. And then as those two systems update each other, Salesforce is updated by the changes to Sagita.
Awesome. So let's see it. I think we've got some pent-up interest in seeing this in action. Okay. So
go ahead and share an application here. So if anybody's familiar with Salesforce, this is an account-level screen within Salesforce. There's tabs across the top, but this is an account. And I've set up a demo account for this particular demonstration. We customized Salesforce within that four-month period to kind of meet our business needs. So when we create an account, we want to know things like who the producer is. We want to know if it's been referred to us from an individual. By tying an account to a referral contact, we are tying it to his organization and we're tying it to his location. So we have an address and a company associated with David Jones, and that tells us who the referral company is, as well as who the individual is. You'll see things in here like record type. So there's two types of record types in our world. There's a Salesforce one, which means it's not in Sagita yet, and there's a Sagita record type. When the thing has been pushed to Sagita, when the account's been pushed to Sagita, we now know it, and then we know it's linked. We capture, you know, what type is it? Is it a suspect? Is it a prospect? Is it a client? Is it the next client? And base information about the account. We can put in one-to-many client contacts at each one of these accounts, and then we can create an opportunity. Now, an opportunity to us is a new business opportunity. That could be either a brand new piece of business. This is a brand new client to the firm, or it could be what we're calling in this system an upsell, which is we already have the client. We're going to sell a new piece of line. We have an opportunity to sell a new piece of business to them. And we track all opportunities, whether it's new business or upsell in Salesforce. So this is a opportunity I created for the demo account. And I'm just going to go down and show you one little thing we do within Salesforce. So we have an approval process that we use internally to check off and assign the resources. When a business opportunity is created by a producer, he tells what business unit it's associated with, and then submits it for approval. And he does that by clicking on a little button up here, says submit for approval. It goes through a two-tiered process, one to the leadership of his business unit, part for informational, but part to make sure that the information is and the opportunity is really qualified. Then it goes to the receiving business unit. That receiving business unit does two things. They look at the size of the opportunity, the fit for our organization, you know, how well qualified it is, and they either approve it or reject it. And when they approve it, they assign the resources. So here is an account executive, and this is a table that is created by Sagita of all of our account executives in the firm, or actually all of our employees in the firm, and it's updated. So if we add a new employee in Sagita, within 5 minutes, that is here and eligible to be added as a resource on an opportunity. So they go ahead and assign one-to-many account executives to an opportunity. They tell us where it's going to book, some basic information that we need from an accounting perspective, and then they go ahead and save that as a assignment. When they do that, all of the account executives get a full-blown synopsis of this opportunity and that they've been assigned and it's going to be in Sagita. The next step is they just go up here and simply click on Send to Sagita. And that sends the account to Sagita so that we're creating a new account in Sagita. And the round trip takes about 15 to 20 minutes. When it gets to Sagita, it automatically creates a new client code for that particular account. It fills in all the high-level account information. It also creates contact information. We do not push policies at this point in time. We are not trying to create new policies within Sagita, but the account header is there. It's ready to go. It's known as a prospect, and the contact information is over. In addition, the account executives assigned get all the attachments that are associated with this particular opportunity. So I had put one down here, I believe. Producers and other people working on it can attach notes or any kind of documents, including policies, things of that nature, any information they might have received from the prospect, that gets pushed to the account executive. So they're in the loop, they know what's going on, and can start working on it in Sagita.
So there was a question here that I think you're really hitting on about, you know, producers really would have very little reason to access the AMS. Is that what your experience has been now?
Yeah, I think that there's a few people who like to get into the nitty-gritty of things, but the vast majority of them would use Salesforce to stay in touch with what's going on with their clients.
Which is great. So you're keeping them all really in that one environment, and the integration between those systems is enabling that.
Right. So I'm going to take you to a second demo that I created earlier and already sent to Sagita, and I'm going to show you what happens to it. You'll notice in this particular case, it tells me the account record type is Sagita. It is no longer Salesforce. It also has a client code. This client code is directly related. That is the client code in Sagita, and the link has been established between the two systems now. If any future updates to this, if I try to send it, it knows the account's already over there, and it's not going to try to update Sagita. We've taken a position that Sagita will be the primary driver of basic information because the account executive is working with the client. We do not want producers updating our Sagita system without the knowledge of the account executive who works on the account day in and day out. So you'll notice that client code is there, the link is there, and any changes in Sagita are going to come back automatically to this account. And I'm going to show you another example of an account that is a real account for us and the types of information that's coming from Sagita. Again, this is a Sagita account. It was brought over during the integration. We can see the client code associated with Sagita. But what's new about this is we brought over all the in-force policies. All right, we have a routine, and what we do is we keep current policies, active policies, in Salesforce. And if I click on a particular policy, I can see some more information about it. So I can see coverage description, who the insurer is, the effective and expiration date, what the written premium is associated with it. And we have other information that we tend to hide for most users except for the owner of the account. The owner of the account can see commissions and some other things. That's all part of the integration piece. You'll notice here that the new policies that we're renewing on 1/1 are already here. When the policies that expire at the end of this year or 1/1/2011 have gone past their expiration date, they will be deleted, and the current policies, the 2011 policies, will be all that's left in this particular. So we're keeping in-force policies only. We do not see Salesforce as a billing system or an account management system, but what it does allow the producers to do is really keep track of all the relationships that they have with the clients, all the meetings, all the information they gather from them, and all of that can be loaded in activities, in activity history, emails, notes, attachments, all of that is kept. So it gives the producer a place to really keep almost a briefcase on their client, everything they've ever done with them. It's integrated to Outlook. It is so any emails that go out are automatically attached, and there's a couple different ways to do that. Any contacts that you might have in your Outlook can easily be synced up with Salesforce, and that is a bi-directional sync as well.
Hey, so Vincent, I mean, it's amazing stuff you're showing here. I mean, Salesforce is clearly a big hit at the company. So can you remind, so you said you started the implementation in January. I mean, how hard is it to do this? I know you mentioned you'd worked with a partner called Silverline. I mean, how did that all take place? What had to happen for this to go from where you were to where you are now?
Well, the first thing we did was we assembled a team internally to basically define our requirements. We had pieces of it together, but we really needed to sit down with Salesforce, with a consultant, and with the Salesforce tool, and really define all of these drop downs and what information we wanted to capture, what were the values that we had in each one of these drop down lists, things of that nature, and map out that approval process. So we formed a team representing all the brokerage units as well as business development, and we sat down and worked through that with our partner, our consultant, Silverline. Silverline captured all that, documented it, made the modifications to Salesforce. We started that first meeting was in this second week of January. I think it was January 10th or 11th or something like that. So we started our requirements gathering in January, and we delivered all of the functionality in Salesforce in late March and all of the integration by the third week of April. So the process itself was, somewhat time-consuming. We met twice a week during that period of time, but incredibly fast when we actually decided what it is we wanted to do to develop, change Salesforce, build the integration piece, migrate the data, and deliver it to the users. It was all live by the end of April.
Awesome. And there's been a couple of questions. We talked earlier about the importance of being able to measure and manage your business with a CRM system like Salesforce. Are you using dashboards? Is that somehow, are you able to sort of determine the ROI or overall adoption through dashboards? And then another question about mobile. Are your producers out there using Salesforce Mobile?
Yes, they are using Salesforce Mobile, mainly on Blackberries, but other phones as well. They do like that. We do use dashboards heavily. We use it for both adoption, but also to really start to show and keep in front of people the major opportunities that are in front of us. So I don't want to take you to our homepage because you'll see a dashboard with all of our major opportunities. Our top 10s in each of our business units are prevalent, and it's right in front of management all day long. They can see what the close date is, how big the opportunities are, what types of opportunities, and who the prospects are. I think I can take you here.
Yeah, we don't want you to expose more than you should.
So for instance, this is the adoption dashboard. So it shows us in the last 7 days how many people have logged in. This shows us how many accounts have been added to Salesforce on a monthly basis. This obviously was our big migration. Information came from three sources. We brought over all our Sagita accounts for ever and ever, even things that don't have any activity because they're prospects for us. We also pulled data from around the country from Hoover's. Good, clean data that met the criteria of the size companies, the industries that we wanted, and we loaded those. That was about 8,000 suspects, if you will. And then producers had another list that they kept in spreadsheets and all sorts of forms. We went through it and cleaned it up a little bit, brought it up into Salesforce, and then used Hoover's access Hoover's to update that information, so the information was very consistent. We now had sales, number of employees, understood their SIC code and all of that stuff. So we went through that process to get the data nice and clean in Salesforce. And then most of this other activity is the number of accounts we generate each month in new business referrals. A lot of those are coming in our private client group, as you would imagine. But it's a substantial number of new accounts that comes through the pipeline every single month.
Maybe you can just remind, because the focus here is really on the integration. How important has integration been to your success with Salesforce? I mean, what if that wasn't there? Do you think there would have been this level of adoption?
Well, I don't think there could have been, because without ongoing integration between Sagita and Salesforce, new accounts put into Sagita would have to be dual entered into Salesforce, which means any cross-sell opportunities in Salesforce would be a major undertaking to load the whole client, start from scratch. So I think, to be honest with you, given what we were setting out to do, which was to really manage our pipeline, manage the relationships with our existing clients, look for cross-sell and rounding opportunities within our book, it would be impossible to do without this integration piece. And from the get-go, when we bought Salesforce, there was no question we were going to integrate it to Sagita. We had to do it.
Great. One of our customers recently said, Salesforce without integration is like a beautiful island that nobody can get to. So it's great validation of that from Frank Crystal.
Yeah. Just think about these transactions having to be dual entered, or the last thing any organization wants is two sets of information that people sit around and arguing about which one's right. And the reality would be neither one of them are even close. So, Salesforce would know things that Sagita didn't know. Sagita would know things Salesforce didn't know, and it would be a nightmare to try to manage it. Most of our accounts getting added get added through Salesforce. It's not to say that we don't load an account occasionally in Sagita, and if we do, it pushes it right up to Salesforce. It's up there in minutes. So it's irrelevant, really, as to where we add an account into the organization. We can do it in either place, but they're synchronized, almost simultaneously.
Great. So there's a couple other questions coming in, but I think, is there anything else on the demo front that you think we should
see? No, I was pretty much done. Any questions, I'd be glad to share my experience with people.
Okay. Well, let's go back to the presentation, and just to close out, because you did have some best practices to share and some recommendations for attendees. While we're doing that, there was a question that was about specifically around quoting. Where do you do your quoting and or binding? And another question about, back to this sort of life before Salesforce plus Informatica. How are you now looking at the overall benefits of this this approach versus what you once were doing?
So all our quoting and all of our detailed policy work is all done in Sagita. We do not do any of that in Salesforce. in terms of what's different in life, as I think I mentioned earlier, we had a very short view of what was coming down the pipe. We had maybe 2 months worth of new business opportunities, but we really couldn't see any further out in terms of what opportunities exist, what kind of revenue, is our pipeline big enough to hit our sales goals in each of these brokerage units. All that stuff was kind of, you know, blurry, and this has really started to allow us to look much further in advance. The other thing it allows us to do is measure activity, because if we're making the calls, if we're sending out the marketing campaigns and measuring exactly the results of those marketing campaigns, we know that the opportunities will come and we'll close our share of them. So it really does allow us to focus on doing the right thing and driving the activity, not just, you know, why isn't the pipeline big enough? Kind of looking at the pipeline only. So it's quite a bit different. Now, we're all of 5 months into this, so we've got a lot to learn. And, one of the things we've just started launching is marketing campaigns. And we've had a couple sessions with Salesforce to look at how we integrate the marketing campaigns that we've been doing kind of independently right back into Salesforce. So we know every prospect we've hit with a marketing campaign, things of that nature. I put down here a couple of lessons learned that I think are kind of critical if you're thinking about going to a CRM like this. Is I would say that bidirectional integration is absolutely critical. One, for adoption. Two, to keep the data in sync and stop people from arguing over which version of the information is right. It really does expose the agency management system to producers and senior management. I mean, our senior managers, and I don't know about your agencies, but our senior managers rarely go in and surf Sagita. Some of them know how to get in there, but it's not a kind of a practice of theirs, and now they have access to information they just didn't have at their fingertips before. And one of the issues that we faced was, I think you really need to think through the data requirements on the agency management system side and build those rules up front into Salesforce. Our approach at first was nothing's really required in Salesforce. It's kind of, you know, it'll build over time. And what ended up happening is things were getting sent to Sagita that were not complete enough. It didn't have all the information it needed to really be effective. So things were getting, hung up when it got to the Sagita side. And the people who knew that information really were the producers in many cases, or the people doing the resource assignment. And we've gone back and put some additional rules in to Sagita to Salesforce to make certain things mandatory. And that has been, a little bit of rework, but nothing major. We're now complete with that process. So everything that gets over to Sagita now is complete, it's accurate, and can be worked on immediately by the account executives.
Fantastic. So Vincent, thank you for taking us through, you know, such a great amount of information and detail, especially in light of the fact that you probably got a few competitors on the call. But really, really great overview. I got a couple of questions, actually, that I'd like to bring you back into the discussion, Jared. Some questions about some of the basics of the platform. One question was about, is Informatica a subscription service or is it a one-time integration fee? Another question about, Salesforce and Informatica, are they on internal servers or the cloud model? And then, we'll hit those. Maybe you can just talk through, how Informatica Cloud works and how Salesforce works from a, architecture perspective.
Yeah, good question. So if you look at Informatica Cloud, it is a subscription service just like Salesforce. As you can see on this screen, you can sign up for a 30-day trial like Salesforce. And we have, just like Salesforce, we have additions so that have different price points that scale up to meet your needs. So that's the pricing model and how it runs. And then, to dig into a little bit on what sounded like some architecture-type questions, you do all your configuration. Everything's in the browser, the six-step wizard, the self-service model that makes it easy to use no matter kind of the size of your company or the resources you have access to. And then you have the option if you want, to access on-premise systems. We have a component that can be deployed on-premise so that it meets all your security requirements, et cetera, and connects to your agency management systems, et cetera. And so that, you know, we could drill into to the security and probably a longer discussion, but that in a nutshell is the architecture.
Okay, great. So yeah, lots of basic questions coming in on that around the architecture and different ways that Informatica Cloud works. So I definitely would recommend people point your browser to informaticacloud.com. We also have a trust site if you're interested in really seeing, you know, digging into more about security and you know how much data is moving through the cloud service today. You can go to trust.informaticacloud.com. But as Jared said, really the key is to go and get started with the trial. You know, if you're just thinking about Salesforce, the Informatica Data Loader is the most popular AppExchange app. So, you know, just go to the AppExchange and get started with that. And you can get a taste for some of the bi-directional data integration capabilities and then move up to the different editions that Jared referenced. So another question while we've got you here, Vincent, specifically on if people are interested in the marketing campaign plans, are you using a marketing automation system? How does that integrate with your AMS environment today, and how will that integrate going forward?
Yeah, we've been using electronic email distribution marketing materials for quite some time in our employee benefits area and in some of our other practices. And the reality was it was not integrated with any other system. So we really had no record, you know, available to us of the types of marketing materials clients would have kept. It was all outside services that we're using to do that, those pushes. And we would track the campaign for a period of time, and then we'd move on to the next campaign. So it wasn't something that really we constantly kept up with how all the campaigns did. So we are moving towards a solution that's integrated with Salesforce so that when we want to build a list, we build it from Salesforce. We send it via, you know, a facility that then integrates back to Salesforce and keeps a record of every single email that any one of our prospects receive. And those services tend to take care of tracking number of times people click on it, forward it, click through to other information that we might provide, and really be able to track that. And Salesforce will actually track the number of opportunities created from that particular campaign, and you link those opportunities to the campaign. So we can not only see, you know, the activity that happened once the email went out in terms of clicks and things of that nature and forwards, we can also see that the actual revenue generated by any particular campaign. So we're working on that right now. That's our current project. We've spent some time with Premier Support going through campaigns and how we're going to manage them, and we're actually going to shift, because of the integration with Salesforce, we're going to shift the outside vendor that we're using now to a new one that will integrate much better.
Okay, great. So I think we're at the end of our scheduled time. Lots of questions still coming in. I just wanted to take a minute to thank everybody, especially Vincent from Frank Crystal, for really participating and sharing your best practices and experiences with Salesforce and Informatica. Two points I wanted to highlight. For those folks on the East Coast, the Informatica World Conference is coming up in November. And then for people that are working with Salesforce or thinking about working with Salesforce, you absolutely need to experience Dreamforce in December. Informatica will be there in a big way, and we'd love to talk to you at that event. And, you know, if you've never been, I'm telling you, find a way to get there. It is the best conference you'll have ever attended. So thank you, everyone, for joining. And this, we will be sharing the presentation and the recording for attendees. And we also had some questions about, you know, list of AMS systems we support. So we will follow up with you on those specifically as well. And I'd like to thank you again for all of your great questions. It's been a very, hopefully you found it to be an informative webinar. Thank you, Vincent. Thank you, Jared. And thanks, everyone, for attending.
Thank you for your participation. This concludes today's conference. You may now disconnect.